We are solving problems using the operations on signals, which we have learned on the independent and dependent parameters of a signal. Here, the first problem is regarding the given x of t, which is 1 from 0 to 4, okay? And it is 0 elsewhere. So this signal is 1 from 0 to 4. This is continuous time signal. And we are asked to sketch and label these. Given x of t, you're asked to sketch these signals, these four signals. Fine. Now, can anybody tell me what is the first signal that which operation is being performed on x of t? Which operation is being performed on x of t? So x of t minus 2, what is that operation? Let's sketch that in the solution. So we need to have x of t with us, okay? And what is being asked is to sketch x of t minus 2. Fine. Now, x of t minus 2 is time shift property. Understand this? So using time shift, it's not property, but it's time shift operation. Understand that? So in time shift operation, x of t is being shifted. Tell me, x of t is being shifted to the right or to the left here? If it is t minus 2, it is being shifted to the right by 2 seconds. If it is t plus 2, it is being shifted to the left by 2 seconds. Okay, so since it is t minus 2, it is being shifted to the right by 2 seconds. That means the signal which was starting at 0 should now start at 2 and it should end at 6. So this is what is x of t minus 2 is. So this is shifting x of t by 2 positions to the right. Okay, so that is what you can write that if you want. Shift x of t to the right by 2 positions or 2 seconds. So that is what x of t minus 2 is, time shift property. Now x of 2t, what is x of 2t? This x of 2t, it is time scale. This is time shift. Time shift. Okay, so what we are going to see next is time scale, that is x of 2t, and the time is being scaled by a factor 2, which is greater than 1. That means the signal should compress or expand. It is being multiplied, the time is being multiplied by a number greater than 1. So that means keep this, always this is the reference for you. Fine. So the one which is extending from 0 to 4 should get compressed by a factor 2. That means the one which is extending from 0 to 4 should now extend from 0 to 2. Understand? So this is what is x of 2t. That means it is x of t compressed by a factor 2. Everybody understand that now? So what operation is it? This is time shift operation. This is time scale operation. Everybody, just this is for your reference. This is time scale operation. Then we need x of t by 2. This is also time scale, okay? But x of t by 2 is scaling time by a number which is less than 1. Okay, see here, this is x of by 2 or x of 0.5 t, anything you can call it. Okay, so now you are scaling it by a number which is less than 1. So what should happen now? What should happen to this x of t? This x of t should now expand by a factor 2. Okay, so if it expands by a factor 2, what should happen? See here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Earlier, what is the range here? 0 to 4. Now x of t by 2 means it should get expanded by a factor 2. So that means it should be doubled in the range. So that means it should go now from 0 to 8. Okay, so that is what we need to write here. So scaling it by a scaling it by a number which is less than 1, or scaling it by a number 0.5 should double its range. Okay, so this is what is it. So x of t expanded by a factor 2. So this is also time scale only. The operation that you have seen here is also time scale. Then what they have asked, x of minus t. Can anybody tell me what is x of minus t? X of t is here. What is x of minus t? Can you go on? What should happen? X of minus t is the reflection. Reflection means what? You need to have the mirror image of this. So you need to have this signal as a mirror image on this side. Okay, so how is that going to look like? X of minus t. X of minus t is what we are looking at. Okay, it's a reflection of x of t. Fine. The signal which was ranging from 0 to 4 should now range from 0 to minus 4. Okay, so this is what is x of minus t is. Yeah, Gokul Krishna, you want to ask something? So this is...
Yes, sir,
Gokul Krishna, you can go on.
Why shouldn't the signal start from 1?
If you have anything to ask, yes, you can ask me.
Yes, sir. I'm confused on
this
the second and third...
We need to sketch. Understand that?
Sir?
Yeah, after going through the first problem, okay? So let's see the second problem here. And before going to the second problem, let's understand that. So the last operation that we perform on x of t is actually reflection operation. Reflection operation. So that means if x of t is ranging from 0 to 4, then x of minus t would range from 0 to minus 4. Fine. Now see the second problem. So what is the difference between the first problem and the second problem? The main difference is in the first problem, the continuous time signal was given. Now in the second problem, the discrete time signal is given. That is why it is x of n. Fine. So again, they are asking us to sketch and label these operations being performed on x of n. So what is x of n minus 2? This is again, this is what? Shifting x of n to the right by two positions. What is x of 2n? X of 2n is time scale operation. And we should know in time scale operation, okay, we lose some of the samples. You remember that in discrete time, if we scale the time, we lose some of the samples. Which samples we are going to lose? Anybody remember that? If we perform the time scale operation in discrete time, we'll be losing some samples. So which samples we'll be losing is what we need to be thinking of here in the second sketch. And the third sketch is again, what? The reflection of x of n. So let's do that now, one after the other. So everybody, I hope you have copied this. Let's go on with the sketch in the solution. Yeah, so I'll just extend this line further down. Yeah, the first signal that I'm taking is x of n minus 2. Fine, now x of n minus 2 is shifting x of n to the right by 2 positions. So now see here, in x of n, we have samples ranging from 1 to 4. Okay, so when you shift this x of n by 2 positions, what should happen? This whatever is there at 1 should shift by 2 positions. That means this should come at 2 and 3. And this should come at 3 and 4. This should come at 4. This should come at 5. So likewise. So you just need to have this signal. Now this is starting at 1. Now the same signal should start at 3 because you have to shift it by 2 positions. Understand that? So let's have this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So the signal which is starting at 1 should now start at 3. Okay. And this is how it is going to look like. Fine. So this is 1. This is 2. This is 3. You can write that 1, 2, 3 here, or you can write at the samples itself. So what operation is performed here again? You should know it is time shift operation. Fine. What is being done? X of n shifted to right by 2 positions. Now, the second one is important, x of 2n. We are scaling the time by a factor 2. Okay, so see what's going to happen here. X of 2n. Fine. Now, let's take this. Now, this is the reference. We are operating on this. We are not operating on this, mind you. Most of the times people, when they are performing this, they'll perform this on this. No, that will be a mistake. So always remember the given signal is what we are operating on. Fine. So on this signal, if you perform x of 2n, the sample at 2 should come at 1. The sample at 3 should come at 1.5. The sample at 4 should come at 2. Okay. And the sample at 1 should come at 0.5. But 0.5 is not there on this axis n. Okay, the sample at 3 should come at 1.5, but that 1.5 is not there on the axis n. Okay, so that means I don't have 0.5, I don't have 1.5, I don't have 2.5, because n is always the integer instance of time. Okay, we don't find numbers like 1.5, 2.5, 3.5 and all. So they are integer numbers. N is an integer. So that's why this sample at 2 will come at 1. The sample at 4 will come at 2. But the sample at 1 will vanish because there is no 0.5. The sample at 3 will vanish because there is no 1.5. Understand that? So at the end, how is it going to look like? X of 2n now. So everybody, see here. The sample at 3. Sample at 2 should come at 1. Fine. And sample at 4 should come at 2. So that is having the amplitude 3. This is 2 and this is 3. Okay, so this is how it looks. So what's happening? This is time scale. This is n. So what's happening is time scale operation. Okay. Now in this time scale operation, what's happening? The odd numbered samples are vanished. Okay. Why they are vanishing? I've been telling you again and again. This 2 should come at 1, 1 should come at, the sample at 1 should come at 0.5. No, it's not there. 0.5 is not to be seen. The sample at 3 should come at 1.5, but 1.5 is not to be seen there. So that's why the odd numbered samples would vanish. The only samples at even numbered n. So 2 will come at 1 and 4 will come at 2 will remain here in the time scale signal. Okay. And the third one is reflection. Reflection of the signal. X of minus n. Understand that? Now, x of minus n means you have to draw the reflection of this. The sample at 1 should now come at minus 1. The sample at 2 should come at minus 2. Sample at 3 should come at minus 3. And 4, the one at 4 should come at minus 4. That means here you are standing and looking into the mirror, and the mirror image of this should come here. The reflection of this should come here. Okay. So how would that look like? It would look like this. This very, very simple stuff we are doing. Okay. Just have to understand what operation and what it results in. So the sample at 1 should come at minus 1. The sample at 2 should come at minus 2. The sample at 3 should come at minus 3. The sample at 4 should also come at minus 4. So this is what is x of minus n. Okay, so this is a reflection operation. I hope you have followed what is being done there. In this third problem, x of n is given, which is 1 at n equal to 1, minus 1 at n equal to minus 1, and 0 for n equal to 0 and for magnitude n greater than 1. And we need to sketch x of y of n, which is sum of x of n plus x of minus n. Okay, sum of these two signals. So let's draw x of n. X of n is 1 at n equal to 1. Okay, it is 1 at n equal to 1, and it is minus 1 at n equal to minus 1. So this is what x of n is. And what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of this? Let's see. So it says for magnitude n greater than 1 means for n greater than 1 and for n less than minus 1 is the meaning of this. Understand? Okay, the meaning of magnitude n greater than 1 means positive n greater than 1, negative n less than 1, or n less than minus 1. See, this is less than minus 1. These are all less than minus 1. Till from starting from minus 2 to minus infinity, it is less than minus 1. Starting from 2 to infinity, it is greater than plus 1. So this is what is the meaning of that. Everybody is okay with that. So this is what is the meaning of writing magnitude n greater than 1. Fine. So remember this. This is short form of writing this magnitude n greater than 1. Fine. Now, what they have told us, you need to have x of n as well as x of minus n to plot y n. Okay. So have x of minus n, everybody. Do it yourselves. I'm anyways doing, but you can do it yourselves. Yeah. So what is there at 1 should come at minus 1. What is there at minus 1 should come at plus 1. So this is how the things look like now. So this is x of minus n. Now what they're asking us is to add these two signals. Okay, so they want us to sketch y of n, which is sum of x of n and x of minus n. Okay, now can you do that sketch? So we have just two samples. One sample is at minus one, the other sample is at one. Okay, now let's see at one what all we have. So at one, you see you have a in x of n, at one you have one, and in x of minus n, at n equal to one, you have minus one. So if you add one and minus one, you will left with a sample. You'll be left with a no sample or a sample with magnitude zero or amplitude zero. Similarly, here on the negative side at n equal to minus one, x of n is minus one and x of minus n is plus one. Again, if you add minus one and plus one, that is going to give you zero. So this is what is your y of n is. After solving these three problems, let's take a rule, okay? And that rule is called as precedence. Precedence, we can call it as precedence. Rule. Okay, for time shifting and time scaling. Precedence rule for time shifting and time scaling. Everybody just copy it down. It's very important. Now, when the time shift and time scaling are there in the same signal at a time, so then only we go for something called as precedence rule. Precedence, what should come after what is the meaning of precedence. Understand that? Now, you all understand what is time shift. Everybody just see here. Time shift is given by x of t minus a. Let me take this as time scale we shall take first. Okay, so let's see the time scale. If you take, it is given by x of a t. Okay, and this is given as x of t minus b. Okay, I'm using A for shifting, sorry, scaling, and B for shifting. Understand that? Now, if x of A t is there, it is just scaling the time by a factor A. If shift is there, it is shifting x of t by B units to the right. So this we understand. Okay, so precedence rules helps when we have time scale and time shift together. That means x of at minus b. Together this is. So precedence rule, what it does is, precedence rule tells us which operation to perform first, which operation to perform first, whether we should perform the scaling or shifting is what the precedence rule tells us. Understand which operation to perform first. Okay, to understand that, we need to follow something called as precedence rule. Everybody understand that?
Yes.